Hello friends, in the previous lecture we have got to know that is what is chemical bond and what are the types of chemical bond, and in that case we have got to know that is the first one was basically ionic bond. So now let us understand that is what is ionic bond, and let us understand it with the help of an example. So let us do it. So now let us understand that is what is actually ionic bond. So the bond formed by the complete transfer of one or more electrons from an electropositive atom to an electronegative atom, leading in the formation of ions which are held together by electrostatic force of attraction, and that is what the ionic bond is, or we could call it as electrovalent bond. So let me give you an example and let us discuss this again, that how and which one are being called to be the ionic bond. So suppose in this case, I'm getting the same example that I have discussed earlier, and that is basically NaCl, and suppose this is what I want to talk about. So whenever we have to combine sodium and chlorine atom, suppose these two are atoms, then we will obtain that is NaCl. But talking about the electronic configuration of sodium, so sodium is the one that could be written as in this form, that is sodium 11. And that could be written as an electronic configuration that could be 2, 8, 1. Well, that of the chlorine atom, when we are talking about that one, so therefore chlorine atom, which has an atomic number of 17, so therefore it could be written as 2, 8, 7. So these are the two things that are being combined with each other so as to form that is NaCl. So this is not the thing that forms directly. Obviously various processes are going on, and in the transfer of electrons that takes place over here, then only the NaCl bond is formed. So suppose what happens is whenever we take a sodium and we react it with chlorine, this doesn't give us the NaCl directly. Obviously that is the thing that we are going to showcase, that is it will convert into ion first, and that ion would be turned into and it will form a bond, and that is a molecule will be formed of NaCl. So the first thing that I am going to talk about is sodium, along with that of the chlorine atom. But sodium has an electronic configuration of 2, 8, 1. While that of the chlorine, which has an electronic configuration of 2, 8, 7. So during this process, what happens is, now sodium is the one which has an outermost electron, or we could say the valence electron is basically one. So, and it is not behaving like any kind of noble gas because of its electronic configuration. So obviously it has to give its electron to someone else. And meanwhile, if you talk about the chlorine is the one which is needful of a particular electron, because if it get one electron, so now this will have an electronic configuration of 2, 8, 8, and that is somewhere like of the argon. And meanwhile, while giving the electron to the chlorine, sodium will turn into basically 2, 8, and that electronic configuration is of neon. So that's the reason that one electron can be transferred to this one. And meanwhile, transfer is nothing, it is not only to give, but it is also to take. So that's the reason that the one electron can be given to the chlorine. And that is how we could say that Na will turn into basically Na plus while giving electrons. So while this one would be basically 2, 8, and the other one, that is the chlorine atom, that will turn into basically Cl minus because it has accepted one electron. So now this will have 2, 8, 8 electronic configuration. But meanwhile, this is behaving like that of we could say neon 10, and this is behaving like that of, you could say, as argon 18 because of its electronic configuration. And now, because since they are converted into their respective ions, and now there will be force of attraction, and that's the reason that we could say that is because of the sharing, or because of the transfer of electrons, and the transfer of electrons takes place in such a manner, and we could write it in this way also, that is they are transferring their electrons, and that's the reason that we could find the bond, that is Na, which is forming bond with Cl, and that is because of complete transfer of electrons, and that is how the bond has been formed. So this is what is an example of the electrovalent bond, or we could say as ionic bond. Only one electron of a basically electropositive atom was been shared, and that is how the bond is formed over here. But let me give an other example. That is, what if we say that is the bond formation of CA, which is forming that is CaCl2. So let me discuss about this thing also. So talking about the first one, that is for calcium. Calcium is the one which has an electronic configuration of that is, we could write it as that is 2, 8, that is it could be written as 2, 8, 2. But that of the chlorine, that could be written as, and since I am talking about one chlorine atom, so there will be two chlorine atoms over here. So the one chlorine will be have basically 2, 8, 7. While the other one will also have that is obviously it is the same item, that is 2, 8, 7. So if you observe in this thing, that is the calcium, that is the calcium atom, it has not the valency like that of a noble gas, because it has a valency of 2 electrons, as the noble gas has a valency of 8 electrons in its outermost shell and except the helium. And that's the reason that it has to lose its 2 electrons to someone. And now it will become like 2, 8, 8 after giving 2 electrons, and that is how it will behave like argon. But meanwhile, chlorine atom is the one which needs electrons. So this 2 electrons means I'm talking about the 2 electrons that are being given by, if they are given by calcium, then that 2 electrons in which one electron would be accepted by one chlorine while the other electron can be accepted by the other chlorine atom, and that is how the octet of all the three could be maintained like that of a noble gas, and that is how the bond will form between these two. And let us see how it forms. So the first of all, that it has to transfer it electron, and it will convert into basically Ca will be converted into basically Ca2 plus by giving out its electron and having an electronic configuration of that is 2, 8, 8. So among the 2 electrons that have been transferred, and in that case one electron will be accepted by each chlorine atom. So therefore we could say that the chlorine atom is the one which will have an electronic configuration of 2, 8, 8, and that chlorine will have a negative charge on. So meanwhile, the other chlorine will also have the same sequence, that is what we have talked about, that it will again accept one electron that was been donated or that was been transferred by the calcium. And now basically calcium is the one which is having, which is behaving like a positive charge species, while that of the chlorine which is acting like a negative charge species. And in this case, if you observe, this is the one which is behaving or which has an electronic configuration like that of the argon 18. Meanwhile, everyone will have an electronic configuration like argon 18, and basically most of the thing, everyone is now being stable in terms of the electronic configuration. But there will be force of attraction also, because this is the positive charge that we have got and this is the negative charge that we have got over here. So obviously there will be force of attraction, and that is what you could see, that the calcium will form basically two bonds, that is one with that of a chlorine atom and another will again with that of a chlorine atom. So meanwhile, in this case basically calcium has donated its 2 electrons to the chlorine, or we could say transferred its electron to the chlorine, and chlorine has accepted that electron from the calcium, and this is how the bond forms, and this is what we have taken example. So now therefore the calcium which is more electronegative, and calcium and chlorine which is more electronegative, so therefore there will be a force of attraction, and this is what we have got over here. So a bond is formed. That's it, friends. That is what I was going to talk about. And thank you for watching this video. I hope you have understood this video very clearly, and you have got to know the concept behind what is ionic bond, or we could call it as electrovalent bond. So this is what it has followed octet rule, and that's it. So I hope you have understood this video, and you will share this video with friends. And just don't forget to subscribe to Ekeeda channel. Thank you so much.